Welcome back to Book of Unwritten Tales. I'm your host, Lostwolfe. This is episode 3. So, we came down here, and we'd been meaning to talk to Granddad, so let's go do that.
Granddad?
Call me Colonel!
Just what exactly are we to do now, Colonel Granddad?
We've just discussed that. You get the equipment, I'll sort out the means of transport.
Equipment for what?
For what? For your journey to the town of the humans, of course. You need to pay more attention, my boy.
I'm supposed to... I thought someone else...
Who? I very much doubt you'll find anyone else here who's prepared to look death in the eye. This is your chance to be a tragic hero, my boy. A painful loss for the Alliance. Don't you want to be a hero?
Sure, I'd like to do something exciting, but I'm not sure I'm ready to try being a...
Try? There is no try, only do. This is your chance. You'll be a hero, and I'll show everyone that this old gnome is still good for something. So, here's the plan. You get yourself some good gear, I'll sort out the means of transport.
All right. I can have a look around, but no promises.
There is no try, there is only do, of course, is a Yodaism. Okay, so about my equipment, what was all that stuff I need? What do you think this ring is all about, then? What exactly am I supposed to get into the... just exactly how am I supposed to get into the human's town? And the Master Bird doesn't want to help me. So then I'll keep on looking. Let's start with the ring.
This ring, do you really think it could end the war?
I don't know if there's anything that can end this war.
The Gremlin said it would change all our fates. Maybe it's a powerful magic ring.
We are simply soldiers, my boy. We fight when we are told to. Don't worry yourself about anything else.
Sounds sensible.
The Archmage of the Humans. Who is that?
Do you know the Archmage? Have you ever met him?
I've never met him. After all, he's a great leader, and I'm just a simple, highly decorated gnome colonel. But I've heard lots about him. He's a powerful mage, of course. He's an advisor to the king, and he's our most powerful alchemist and chief of the secret service. He lives in a tower down by the sea in Seastone. Of course, being the important man he is, he's always away on business.
I hope he's there. I always wanted to meet a real mage.
If he's not there, you'll have to wait for him or go and look for him. You must only give the ring to the Archmage in person, you hear me? No one else. Give me your word of honor. If the ring really is important, then it shouldn't be our fault if it lands in the wrong hands.
Okay, okay. I swear I'll give it to the Archmage personally.
About my equipment, we'll deal with that last, but let's talk about the other stuff. How exactly am I supposed to get into the human's town?
I'm supposed to travel to the human town in your machine, right?
Absolutely, it's the quickest way.
And the safest?
Absolutely, it's the quickest way.
I love that. He doesn't actually say it's the safest, he just says it's the quickest way. Master Brewer doesn't want to help me.
Well, we can't expect any help from the Master Brewer. He doesn't believe the ring is important.
I didn't expect much more from that cowardly drunkard.
Grandad, he's my boss.
Some boss sits in his fortress drinking beer from dawn till dusk while his comrades are fighting on the front line.
I think he misses them.
Well, perhaps. But one thing's for sure. We are on our own, soldier.
Let's talk about my equipment.
About my equipment?
Yes? Have you got everything?
I don't know. What exactly should I take?
Let me think. You need a helmet. You can fight without legs, but you can't fight without a head.
Without legs?
And you need a map of the area. Reconnaissance is everything. We are living in the information age.
So I need a map and a helmet. Got it.
And then, of course, you'll need a parachute. Better to be safe than sorry.
A parachute?
Just a precaution.
Okay, so the fact that he is doing this again means that it's going to run a conversation again, which means that this is super important. But we'll just show you that that is the case.
What am I supposed to be getting again?
What am I supposed to be getting again, sir? Helmet, map, and parachute.
Thanks, Grandad. Sir, Colonel.
Alright, you can ask him again, obviously, but he'll say the same lines.
What am I supposed to be getting again?
What am I supposed to be... Helmet!
Thanks, Grandad.
Okay, so let's...
I'll go look for the rest of my gear.
You do that. I've got enough to do here. But remember, never look a Medusa in the eye. And never look at anyone on the underground.
Right.
That last bit was very, very British. And Grandad gets back to where he's going. So there are a couple of things that we can take here immediately. There's an extendable arm. Let's grab that.
Ah, an old extension arm. Very handy if you're too small to reach an object. Kind of a widespread problem amongst us gnomes.
Grab that.
An extension arm with a mechanical hand. These fingers are a little worn, but they can still grab things that don't weigh too much.
And right next to that, there's a toolbox.
That's Dad's spare toolbox. Well, he took his everyday tools, his travel tools, and his finest tools with him.
We need that.
Let's see. What have we here? Wrench, pliers, auger grease, a minotaur foot, a curse meter. I'll just take the entire box.
And into the inventory it goes. As always, the folks in adventure games can carry as much as they want.
Let's see. What have we here?
Oh, okay, it's not going to change that. All right. So, there is some scrap.
Parts of some machine or something. If it's useless, it's Dad's. If it's broken, it's Grandad's. And if it's dangerous, it's from my sister Maggie.
And so we don't need to worry too much about that. There's a machine here. This is for later, but we'll look at it now.
Grandad has this thing about secrecy. I think he's afraid of Shadow Army spies or something. Something my Grandad is working on. No idea what it is. And I'm pretty certain I don't want to know either. I like my Grandad, but his inventions are usually pretty dangerous.
We don't need to deal with that anymore. Right. Of course, you can keep talking to Grandad if you want. But there's a machine behind him that we want to look at.
A huge machine? I mean, even for Grandad. He's really taking advantage of Mum and Dad being away.
And again, we don't need to do anything else with it. There is, however, one last thing we can look at over here, which is this.
Dad's vice brings back a lot of memories. Painful, mostly. Dad's vice.
And again, since you can keep looking at it, it's going to be useful in the interim, or some point, anyway. So, I promised that we were going to go look at those levers upstairs. Let's go do that. Okay, so one of the things Walber said was that when you have a gnome hole like this, you have a space problem. So what his dad did was he made these three levers. Each lever connects to a room in the house, and each room has different things in it. So let's start with this one.
Those are the controls for our living space optimization unit. My father invented them. Our kitchen.
Okay, there's a couple of things in the kitchen that we need. Let's stop by looking at the grain mill.
Our flour mill. Mother makes sure we eat a healthy diet. One day we'll all be big and strong, comparatively. There's still some grain in the funnel. Barley, I think.
We need that.
A good handful of barley from my mother's kitchen.
And now there's nothing else we can do with that. There's a cupboard here.
A pale blue glowing liquid. Something tells me it's probably not good for you. My mum wrote super fertilizer on it. Probably one of her genetic experiments. A vial of my mum's super fertilizer.
And we need
Mum hid the knives as a precaution after Grandad's knife-throwing training classes last year. She doesn't trust us anymore.
There's the scissors, yeah.
Scissors from my mum's kitchen. Sharp and dangerous.
And I think that's all we need from the kitchen. That's my recollection, anyway. Let's go to the next room. We've got the gnome room, which is Maggie. I believe this is Maggie's room, anyway.
This is my very cool room.
Right. We need the rucksack.
My old gnome scout rucksack. Pretty tough, that. But somehow I always had the feeling it could have been a little larger. I wonder if putting small bags and pouches in it would increase the rucksack's capacity. My old gnome scout rucksack.
Okay. There's also a racket.
My old tennis racket, although I was never very good. The catgut is missing. What did I use that for? The frame of my old tennis racket. The catgut's missing.
That's important. The fact that he keeps mentioning it anyway. I think that's all we need out of Wilbur's room. Yeah, those are the two things. Let's do this.
That's the lever for my little sister's bedroom. I'm not touching that. She builds combat robots, and she kind of hinted that she knows how to protect her privacy.
Right, so we aren't going to go to Maggie's room, and then we have the last room.
That's the lever for my parents' bedroom. I can't use it until they get back.
Okay. That should be all that we need. Let's go and... Well, we'll go upstairs. Oh, it's sort of difficult to see, but there's an aisle. We won't do that quite yet. There's an icicle there, but we need it. We need it for a little bit later, though. Let's try and grab the map, because we need that.
It's worth a try. Yikes!
What's happening?
Oh, nothing much. I just scared off a pixie.
What, here? At this time of year? The beasties are getting more and more cheeky.
Phew. That was close. I can't get to the map as long as he's sleeping there. I'll have to distract him somehow.
Which is easy enough to do. We could try and talk to the Master Brewer to get him to move, but that ain't gonna happen.
Master Brewer, sir.
You got any idea where I might find a parachute? Would you happen to have a helmet for me? Could I perhaps have that map there? My grandpa also believes that doing is important. I'll let you carry on sleeping then. Let's start with the map.
Mr. Master Brewer, sir, could I maybe borrow that map over there?
What, that? Oh, lad, that map shows the finest taverns in the land. And this one's on it, too.
Oh, I'd be really, really careful with it.
No. To be quite honest, there hasn't been a lot going on here since war broke out. And I've got no chance of being featured again. That's why the map is staying where it is.
Say, you wouldn't happen to have a parachute, would you?
That's a good un.
No, I didn't think so. As a warrior, you're bound to have a lot of weapons, armor, and helmets and such, right?
What, me? No, why should I? I'm a master brewer, not a warrior.
But you belong to the dwarf army.
Well, aye, but the master brewer doesn't get involved with weapons and all. Even when I was on the battlefield, my job was just sitting on the ox cart and looking after the beer barrels.
Did any of the other dwarves maybe forget a helmet in the bastion?
A forgotten helmet? Never, lad. Them things are precious family heirlooms for us dwarves. You just don't go forgetting stuff like that.
Too bad. I guess I'll have to look elsewhere then. I talked to my granddad. He thinks the ring is important too. He wants to help me get to the human town.
Yeah? Well, of course he wants to do that. Listen to me, laddie. Nothing against your grandpa, but don't you think he's a few gills short of a pint?
My granddad is a great soldier and inventor.
Of course he is. Of course he is. But, how should I put it? He's maybe had one crash landing too many. His flying machines were mostly a bit, temperamental. And let's face it, he wasn't actually the greatest of pilots. Honestly, son, if your grandpa reckons there's something in that story, then for me, that's just one more reason to keep out of it.
Grandad and I will show everyone. I don't want to trouble you any further. Good night.
And yourself. Have a good one.
Man. Again, I like the Master Bruce voice, but that's just... it's not kind. Oh, hang on. Before I even do this.
Beards are important to dwarves. The longer the beard, the more respect the dwarf gets. And the beard ornaments tell you a lot about their owner. The Master Brewer, for example, is a second-degree keg roller. He was born the 9th of 12 children, and he's got a weak spot for beer. He's a bachelor, but isn't one for walks in the morning dew. And he was almost kicked out of school for pulling a girl's moustache.
We need a bit of his beard.
No, I can't. Maybe I can. I'm gonna burn in hell for this, guaranteed.
I love the way they start the Jaws theme there.
A piece of the Master Brewer's beard. If he ever finds out, I'm history.
Okay, so one of the things that we got from the whole earlier expedition was we got a bit of waste and we had rubbish. And we know that what will happen is that if you give the robot a DNA sample, it will chase whatever it's, you know, attached to. So let's start the machine up.
Let's see how it likes this. Aha! It works!
Now, I'm going to do a mean and rude thing.
I wonder if that would work. At least it would distract the Master Brewer a bit.
No!
Ah! Hello? Stop! That wasn't supposed to happen. I have a feeling that wasn't such a brilliant idea. Oh, I like the Master Brewer.
That was amazing! The eternal struggle of dwarf against machine. And I won!
Are you okay?
Of course! And why not? You think a stupid tin bucket's going to beat a proper dwarf? No chance! That was good. Something's happening at last. Cause for celebration. I think we should drink to that.
Which basically resets the room, which means you can grab this.
I think he's drunk with victory, so he shouldn't see anything. I have it. The map of the area. All I need now is a helmet and a parachute. I hope I don't need to use the parachute. I always like to keep my feet on the ground.
Okay, so let's look at the map.
The map shows the area between here and the human town of Seastone.
Let's see what the Master Burr left behind for us. Ah, okay. We can't get anything from the robot. Interesting. I thought we'd be able to, but we don't. Right. Actually, we can get a helmet pretty quickly and easily. Hold on, do I have everything for that? I have this. The fertilizer, I believe. Though I'm not sure. I believe I'm missing an item from the kitchen.
Our kitchen.
I think.
Master Merlin's antibacterial kitchen cleaner. The dirt disappears like magic. If only I could cast spells like Merlin, or any other household cleaner for that matter.
There we go.
Master Merlin's antibacterial kitchen cleaner. The dirt disappears like magic. If only I could cast...
Right. So now that we have that, we can actually go get a helmet. I need a tarpaulin as well, by the by.
The tarps are supposed to offer the stonemasons a little protection. They have to be pretty tough if they're out there in all kinds of weather. I'm not climbing up there, it's all iced up. I'd probably end up breaking my neck.
Okay. There is another, I believe, tarpaulin here. Oh, I didn't look around.
Probably the statue of some famous dwarven leader. I don't know much about their history. Apparently the statue is not quite finished. Still, it looks much better than the others do. The bastion looks so impressive. However, many of the halls and corridors were never completed. Originally, hundreds of dwarves were supposed to live here to defend the Mountain Kingdom's northern front. Now the Master Brewer and my family are the only ones left.
I believe there's another tarpaulin I can grab on the ground, but I guess I'm not seeing it quite yet. Okay, no problem. I need to go into the kitchen.
That's the Master Brewer's favourite spot. He likes to relax there in the evenings.
That's his chair, obviously. Okay, so if you'll recall, there's this pot here, the cooking pot. But he won't touch the cooking pot without, you know, some kind of assistance. So let's give him some assistance. We're going to collect our arm. We're going to attach this to it.
A perfect fit. Now we can make long-reaching attacks on bacteria.
Which is precisely what we're going to do.
Now I'm going to do something I should have done a long time ago. It's too bad that slime had to be so evil. Now that's a helmet fit for a hero. It only stinks a little bit. So that's two of the three pieces of gear already. So all I need now is a parachute.
Okay.
Now that's a helmet fit.
Okay. It's not going to actually do anything. We need a tarpaulin for the rucksack. One great thing about this game is that you can fast forward action. So if I'm standing over here, and if I go there, I don't need to actually watch the walk cycle all the way going there. I can simply just double click. I wonder if I can get the top one from here. Oh no. There we go. And if you double click on Wobble while he's walking, he will walk a bit faster. Okay. Oh, right.
A rolled-up tarpaulin, probably just like the ones hanging all over the place.
Let's grab that. I'll have a look.
A rip-proof tarpaulin with eyes along the sides, surprisingly light.
There is also, although I'm not sure where it will be, rope around this area. No? Huh. Let's do this at least.
I'll just knot the loose ends around the frame. Done. Wouldn't want to play tennis with it, but it does make a fine scoop net.
Okay, we need that for later. Oh, there we go. There's an icicle which we need.
Of course, it's pretty cold all year round up here in the mountains. But this year, winter came particularly early.
I don't want the icicle quite yet, but we do need it. I'm just looking at my notes. I believe I'm missing some rope somewhere. Okay, well, that's fine. Let's go inside. So, with my, actually, let's have a look at the top pylon.
A rip-proof tarpaulin with eyes along the sides. Surprisingly light.
I can combine this with the rucksack.
That won't work. How am I supposed to attach the tarpaulin to the backpack?
Ah, okay. He really, really wants the rope. I'm not sure where the rope is, but I can do this.
Gotcha.
Okay.
My mechanical flying fish. I built that all by myself. With my dad and Meggy.
And so... I wonder if the rope isn't... I'm pretty sure the rope is outside. I'm just not sure where. Because I don't recall that the rope was down here. Nah, I don't think so. Out we go. I want to say that the rope was somewhere over here. Ah, there we go. No, that's the icicle. I keep getting all excited about the icicle being the rope, but it isn't really. Sebastian. That's still the bastion. Maybe the rope is down on the floor from where MacGuffin fell. No. Okay. Well, let's head on in. I don't recall there being any rope in the kitchen. Thank you. Okay, I tell you what. Since I can't find a rope, I'm going to end the episode here, and what we'll do is we'll find a rope together when I see you next. Thank you so much for watching, my friend, Book Unwritten Tales. I am Lost Wolf, and I hope that you're enjoying this as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. I shall see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now.